St. Louis has the Arch. Seattle, the Space Needle. And Newark, Ohio has this. A basket, a very big basket.
It may be a symbol rising out of the landscape that you didn't expect, but it stands for something, and it stands for really a person who was a big dreamer.
That dreamer's name was Dave Longaberger, a visionary and entrepreneur. Dave learned basket weaving from his father and in time created an empire, making and selling handcrafted baskets in all shapes, sizes, and colors. At its height, the Longaberger Company was a $1 billion-a-year business with 12,000 employees worldwide. With business booming, Dave needed a new headquarters. We'll let his brother, Gary Longaberger, take it from here.
Being Dave, we all thought he was nuts anyway. But he told me one day he was going to build a basket, a building, corporate building that looked like a basket. And I thought, oh my gosh, no.
Gosh, yes. But even the designers and builders didn't quite get it.
The architects and the contractors couldn't picture what he wanted. He actually left the meeting, went downstairs, got one, brought it up and said, this is what I want.
Built in 1997, the Longaberger Basket Building was a sight to behold.
This is a 7-story building. Those handles weigh 75 ton each.
Newark Mayor Jeff Hall says it was no easy feat.
They also are heated. If ice formed on them and would slip off there, it would damage the glass roof on the place for the atrium.
Dave had even grander plans, but then, in 1999, he died from cancer at the age of 64. Next, the economy took a hit. And while Longaberger's baskets didn't change, demand for them did.
Over the last few weeks, we've been moving people out a couple at a time. And now we're down to, I think, 3 or 4 people left to go yet.
Brenton Baker started working at Longaberger when he was 22. He's now the marketing president for JRJR Networks, the Dallas-based company that bought the business in 2013.
The building served us well for many, many, many years. It's not the end of a chapter, it's the beginning of the next era for us.
While there used to be 500 people at work here, Baker is one of the last to remain.
It's been a good 18 years here. I made a lot of friends. A lot of friends through this company.
And he's packing up. You see, last week, Longaberger began moving out. A bittersweet day, to be sure. At the once bustling factory, baskets are still being made by artisans like Michelle Coe, with a personal touch that connects her to every purchase.
Every basket I make has my initials on it, and that goes out all across the country. Where else do you hear that? And it's just, I just love it.
And what will become of this one-of-a-kind landmark? It's now up for sale. Ask Gary Longaberger, and his answer is simple.
You think back to your brother. What would he be thinking? I'd like to see the building taken over and used for whatever purpose. But it's going to take some doing.